located in a deep basin. Xiaozhuang Village is surrounded by cliffs over 1,000 meters high on all sides. Around 400 local villagers had to climb the cliffs there to get to the county seat. Life was hard, as there was no road to the outside world. The annual income there in the 1990s was around 300 yuan, or 24 US dollars. In 1997, 38-year-old Mao Zhanglin was elected secretary of the Communist Party of China branch of Xiaozhuang Village. He made the decision to help villagers out of poverty by building a road. In a selfless effort to build this path to the outside world, he took the lead in signing a liability waiver and wrote, "If I die during the construction, the village must not be blamed for my death."
我们出山的工了嘛，有七八公里，我算过，一天修一米，大二十年修，二十年修不出了，我们还有后代，接着往下修，总有一天会修通的。带领乡亲们，历时七年，在绝壁上凿出一条通向外界道路的重庆市巫山县竹贤乡夏庄村党支部书记毛向林说， 山凿一尺，宽一尺，路修一丈，长一丈，就算我们这代人穷十年、苦十年，也一定要让下辈人过上好日子。
To raise funds to build the road, Mao put all of his money together and raised 700 yuan from his mother, which was his mother's life savings. Deeply moved by his enthusiasm, the villagers collected a further 4,000 yuan in startup capital. Construction of the road started in the winter of 1997. Without any professional equipment, local villagers used homemade and agricultural tools, such as iron picks and hammers, to chisel off rocks on the cliffs.
当时吧，我们都是站在这个箩筐里面。 两腿咱都还在滑头，下面都是完整时间的这个悬崖，上面并且还在落石渣。毛书记第一个嘛，闯在前面，把线排好了，这个腰杆上嘛系的根绳子，老百姓都跟着他下去了。But
a sudden tragedy that took place during the construction almost changed Mao's mind on building the road.
对于修工作，我们还是比较积极。
Just one day after the interview in 1997, 36-year-old Huang Huiyuan died after falling off the cliff when he was hit by rubble.
因为黄慧远手把夯回来的，我对他感觉很内疚，我在想放弃这个修路的念头了。 在黄慧远的灵堂前，我们大家这个路还修不修？黄慧远的父亲黄玉坤第一个站出来。我还是愿望、希望广大群众，哪怕我黄慧远现在还是要努力一把，执政一把，和我们工作组就通道，就摆脱这个贫困呐。
同意修公路的，请举手。
In 2004, after 7 years of hard efforts, the 8-kilometer-long and 2-meter-wide road was finished. The dream of generations had been fulfilled. After more widening and hardening work conducted by the local government, the travel time from a Xiaozhuang village to the county seat was slashed to around 1.5 hours.
毛主任就站出来说：“这条路现在在我们这一代把它修通了，我对得起死去的人，对得起你们父老乡亲们。”向那个牺牲的卢伟同志表示向你们致意，敬你们一杯酒。For
Mao, building a road was the first step towards leading to the next one of seeking a way to prosperity. After consulting experts, he decided to develop orange planting in the village. Now the orange orchard here covers an area of about 43 hectares, and the whole village shook off poverty in 2015.
欢迎更多的客人来下庄观光旅游。